poster of the Unitarian Church of Montreal's mission statement, which says, as a spiritual community, we welcome and nurture, we inspire and challenge, we take action in the world. Well, what's interesting is it doesn't say what Montreal Unitarians welcome and nurture. It doesn't say what Montreal Unitarians inspire and challenge. And it doesn't say what kind of actions Montreal Unitarians take in the world. And the fact of the matter is that this can be interpreted very negatively, because Montreal Unitarians do in fact welcome things and nurture things that can be properly described as immoral, unethical, borderline criminal, actually criminal, and if you don't mind my saying so, also batshit crazy. Similarly, Montreal Unitarians inspire certain things that can again be properly described as unethical, immoral, borderline criminal, actually criminal, and again, batshit crazy. And then as far as challenging things goes, well, sometimes, indeed very, very often, Montreal Unitarians challenge things that actually are ethical and moral and anything but criminal. They challenge and repeatedly challenge my protest against clergy abuse, and they try to shut it down. So again, they basically do things that are immoral, unethical, borderline criminal, actually criminal, and yes, totally fucking insane, if you don't mind my saying so. And then, yes, the actions that they take in the world. Well, earlier today, Stanislaus Makiewicz, I believe is his last name, but I could be wrong about that. But anyway, Stanislaus, the president of the board of the Unitarian Church of Montreal, came out. And as he has done in the past, he came out of the church and he got the hose, the garden hose from the church, which they've extended the length of. Apparently, they extended the length of the hose by about 10 feet or more. And he watered down, erased my chalk slogans that were celebrating 20 years of protest against Unitarian Universalist clergy abuse. And he has in the past erased my chalk slogans that are more specific and actually protest against not just Unitarian clergy abuse, but more specifically child sex abuse committed by Unitarian Universalist ministers and Sunday school teachers, and the cover-up and denial of child sex abuse by Unitarian Universalist leadership, including UUA moderator Jim Key, who brazenly lied about child sex abuse committed by Unitarian Universalist ministers in his utterly worthless official apology to victims of clergy sexual misconduct that he delivered at the